Do you find yourself getting sick often? Did you know that vitamin deficiency may be the cause? This video discusses the crucial role that vitamin D plays in supporting our immune system and how it can prevent illnesses such as flu, colds, COVID-19, and even more serious autoimmune disorders. Recent studies have revealed that vitamin D can increase the production of antimicrobial proteins, which fight off viruses, bacteria, and that even healthy individuals can benefit from supplementation. However, taking vitamin D isn't as simple as popping a pill. It's important to know how much to take, which form of vitamin D to take, and what are other vitamins and minerals that work together with vitamin D to boost the immune system effectively. It's also important to understand what the optimal level of vitamin D is and how was it established to avoid taking too much of vitamin D, which could be harmful. Additionally, there is emerging research suggesting that high doses of vitamin D may lead to calcium deposits into our arteries and causing atherosclerosis. Therefore, we do need to look at how to take vitamin D safely and how to avoid this from happening.
So, what is the connection between vitamin D and immune system?
The link between vitamin D and immune system became first apparent when it was found that receptors for vitamin D are present on almost all cells of the immune system. In fact, researchers have found that vitamin D can increase the production of antimicrobial proteins that help to fight off viruses and bacteria. One study even found that vitamin D supplementation reduces the risk of respiratory infection like flu and pneumonia by up to 50%. So how does vitamin D actually work on the immune system? Well, it turns out that vitamin D helps to activate the immune cells like T cells and B cells, which are responsible for fighting off infections and diseases. Vitamin D also helps to prevent chronic inflammation, which can lead to a range of health problems. But how exactly does vitamin D activate these immune cells? Well, it turns out that vitamin D binds to specific receptors on immune cells, which signal to the cells to start attacking pathogens and infected cells. And as I mentioned earlier, vitamin D also helps to increase the production of those antimicrobial proteins, which further help to protect us against infections. Vitamin D deficiency can significantly impair our immune system function. When we don't get enough vitamin D, our body has trouble producing enough of those antimicrobial proteins we talked about earlier. This means that we are more susceptible to infections and diseases. In fact, studies have shown that vitamin D deficiency is associated with a number of diseases, including respiratory infections, autoimmune diseases, and even some cancers. Now, the role of vitamin D in supporting the immune system is demonstrated by its connection to tuberculosis autoimmune diseases. Studies showed that vitamin D deficiency increases the risk of developing active tuberculosis, while adding vitamin D supplementation to anti-tuberculosis treatments has beneficial effects. Now, in autoimmune diseases such as type 1 diabetes, multiple sclerosis, rheumatoid arthritis, lower levels of vitamin D are often linked to occurrence of the diseases and more frequent flare-ups. However, it is important to note that only true deficiency levels of vitamin D, such as those below 12 nanograms per milliliter, have been correlated with increased prevalence and aggressiveness of those autoimmune diseases. We should also mention that vitamin D insufficiency is defined as serum 25 hydroxy vitamin D level between 20 to 29 nanograms per milliliter, while vitamin D deficiency is defined as serum 25 hydroxy vitamin D level below 20, according to the Endocrine Society Clinical Practice Guideline.
Can you tell us more about the problems associated with low vitamin D levels?
It's important to know that while there is evidence linking low levels of vitamin D to certain health conditions, more research is needed to fully confirm these findings. Some experts suggest that low levels of vitamin D may simply be a marker of illness rather than a direct cause. This theory is based on the fact that inflammation in the body can reduce vitamin D levels, so individuals with high levels of systemic inflammation may have lower levels of vitamin D as a consequence of their illness. In other words, low vitamin D levels may be consequence of illness rather than the cause of the illness. However, Further research is needed to fully understand the relationship between vitamin D and inflammation in the body.
So how prevalent is vitamin D deficiency?
Vitamin D deficiency is very common, and recent studies show that nearly 40% of Europeans have a vitamin D deficiency. Certain populations are at even higher risk of deficiency, including people with darker skin, those who are overweight or obese, and people who live in areas with less sunlight. Factors such as skin tone, age, and time spent indoors can affect vitamin D absorption, making it necessary to keep track of vitamin D levels regularly, especially during the winter months when the sun exposure is limited.
How much vitamin D should we be taking?
Determining the appropriate amount of vitamin D intake can be challenging, as individual needs may vary depending on several factors. According to the National Institute of Health, most adults should aim for daily intake of 600 to 800 units of vitamin D. However, Mayo Clinic suggests that supplement providing 1,000 to 2,000 international units per day of vitamin D is generally safe and can help maintain satisfactory blood levels of vitamin D. In cases where a person's vitamin D level falls below 20, a much higher dose may be necessary to return it to normal. In this situation, a healthcare provider may prescribe a weekly dose of vitamin D at a strength of 50,000 international units for 12 weeks. To achieve even more efficient restoration of vitamin D level, I recommend to my patients to take 1,000 international units of vitamin D every day for 12 weeks in addition to the weekly prescriptions. It is important to recheck vitamin D levels to ensure that they have reached the desirable range. Age, weight, and overall health are among the factors that may influence individuals' requirements. What are the optimal levels of vitamin D that we should be aiming for? Based on observational studies of native tribes in Africa who spend most of their time under the sun without wearing much clothing, as well as individuals who spend great amount of time under the sun, such as surfers and carpenters, the generally accepted safe levels is between 30 to 50 nanograms per milliliter. These individuals had vitamin D levels ranging from 30 to 70 nanograms per milliliter, which appears to be the physiological level corresponding to our lifestyle until about a couple hundred years ago, when we started wearing more clothing and spending less time under direct sun.
What are the best sources of vitamin D?
Now, can you get vitamin D from diet? In research from an article on vitamin D that I published 2 years ago, I did not find any research that would suggest that it is possible to get enough vitamin D from the food we eat. Sure, there are foods that contain vitamin D, but it is virtually impossible to eat enough of those foods to prevent vitamin D deficiency. Some of the highest food sources of vitamin D are fatty fish, cod liver oil, egg yolks, mushrooms such as shiitake and portobello, as well as fortified foods such as milk, orange juice, and breakfast cereals. But the best source is exposure to sun. The bottom line is that to assure that we have adequate amount of vitamin D, we only have two choices. Either get enough sun exposure, which given the risk of skin cancer is becoming less appealing to most people, or take daily supplements of vitamin D.
That brings us to the question, which form of vitamin D is the best for supplementation?
There are two main forms of vitamin D for supplementation, vitamin D2 and D3. So which one is better? Vitamin D3 is generally considered to be more effective for immune system support than vitamin D2. This is because vitamin D3 is the form of vitamin D that is synthesized in the skin when it is exposed to the sunlight. And it is also the form that is naturally found in foods like fatty fish and egg yolks. Vitamin D2, on the other hand, is typically found in fortified foods and supplements, and it may not be well absorbed or utilized by the body as vitamin D3. However, both forms of vitamin D can be effective in raising vitamin D levels in the body. Now, so far, we have been talking about how important is vitamin D for the immune system. But let's be realistic here. Supplementing with one vitamin is not going to entirely change how our immune system works. If you are serious about maximizing the full potential of your immune system, you have to maintain also a balanced diet. that includes variety of nutrients-dense food and avoid all the junk food that suppresses the immune system.
Are there other nutrients that work synergistically with vitamin D to enhance its effect on the immune system?
Absolutely. Recent studies have shown that vitamin D works particularly well with vitamin C, zinc, magnesium and omega-3 fatty acids to support the immune system. Vitamin C is an antioxidant that helps to protect against oxidative damage, which can weaken the immune system, while zinc plays a role in development and activation of the immune system. Magnesium helps to regulate the function of the immune cells, and studies have shown that magnesium deficiency can impair immune function and increase the risk of infections. Furthermore, magnesium also plays a role in activation of the vitamin D, as it is required for the conversion of vitamin D into its active form. Therefore, adequate levels of magnesium are necessary for the proper utilization of vitamin D in the body. Omega-3 fatty acids are essential fats that have anti-inflammatory properties. Chronic inflammation can weaken the immune system, making it more susceptible to infections and other immune-related disorders. Omega-3 fatty acids help to reduce inflammation in the body, which can help to support the immune system. Additionally, studies have shown that omega-3 fatty acids can enhance the function of the immune cells, improve the response to vaccination, and reduce the risk of infection, such as respiratory infections. Together, vitamin D and omega-3 fatty acids work synergistically to support the immune system. Vitamin D helps to regulate the immune response, while omega-3 fatty acids help to reduce inflammation and enhance the function of the immune cells. Now let's talk about vitamin K. Vitamin K is a group of fat-soluble vitamins that play a crucial role in blood clotting and bone metabolism. However, recent research has also shown that vitamin K may have immune modulatory effect. Vitamin K can help to regulate the function of the immune cells and reduce inflammation, which is essential for maintaining a healthy immune system. Vitamin K plays a crucial role in the production of proteins that aid in the transportation of calcium throughout the body, which this is essential for proper calcium utilization. Recent research has indicated that taking vitamin D and vitamin K together may have benefits for overall cardiovascular health. Studies have shown that vitamin K may help prevent buildup of calcium in the arteries, which has been observed in individuals taking high doses of vitamin D supplementation. However, the evidence for the potential benefit of taking vitamin K for this purpose is currently limited. It is recommended to avoid taking high doses of vitamin D beyond the current recommendations unless instructed by a healthcare provider. But this is definitely a topic that's worth keeping an eye on for more studies to be published. To summarize everything that we said today, we can say that current research suggests that vitamin D supplementation may help boost the immune system in its ability to fight off infection and reduce the severity of illnesses, especially when vitamin D is combined with other nutrients. It is also apparent that avoidance of severe vitamin D deficiency improves immune health and decreases the susceptibility to autoimmune diseases. However, it's important to take vitamin D safely and as recommended, and to consult with a healthcare professional before starting supplementation. A balanced diet and regular testing of vitamin D levels are also essential for maintaining optimal immune response function. We hope you learned something new today. If you did, please give us thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you get notified when we publish another video.